Hi students, welcome. Now we are discussing about section of solids topic. First we want to know about how to draw the projection of solid. Then that solid is cut by a sectional plane, we get section of solid. Clear? So as per our problem, our condition is a cube of side 30 mm rest on the HP on one of its base with a vertical face inclined at 35 degree to VP. It's cut by a plane perpendicular to VP and inclined at 35 degree to the HP and meeting the axis at 25 mm above the HP. Draw the front view, sectional top view and true shape of the section. Clear? You draw first X, Y reference line. The cube is initially rest on HP. Therefore, in cube, the top view, it appears square of size 30. And also, the vertical faces inclined at 35 degree to VP, they given. Therefore, first we draw top view. Before that, you draw one inclined line. Clear? That line is 35 degree inclined to VP, this angle. On that line, we made it a given cube. So, anywhere you select it. So, from here. So, here to here. This is cube of size 30 mm. No? So, this one. So, therefore, here the 30 square. Clear? We know that this angle is 35 degree. This is 35 degree inclined to VP. The cube, it consists of 6 square faces. So we assign that letters in top A, B, C and D. For base 1, 2, 3 and 4. You draw the projection lines from top view to front view. Here, here and here. Now the cube, the base is rest, therefore in front view this is the, it appears rectangle shape, because while the cube is two vertical faces are parallel to VP and perpendicular to VP, means the front view also it appears same square 30, but it is slightly inclined to VP. Therefore, the front view it appears only rectangle. The rectangle, this one, the height is 30 because the square 30, no? So, here also 30. This is front view. I understand. So, as per the front view, the A1 edge is visible, C3 edge is visible, similarly B2 edge also visible. Therefore, this is visible initially. Clear? And the D4, that edge is invisible. So, this is the before section of the given solid. It is the top view and front view. I understand. So, this is the case. So, I assign that letters. So, the ABCD is top surface. So, this is A dash. This one is B dash. This is C dash. And this one is D dash. And the base 1, 2, 3, 4. Therefore, this is 1 dash. This one is 2 dash. This part 3 dash. And this one is 4 dash. Clear? So, in the top view, square shape, in front view, rectangle shape. So, this is the given cube only in projection of solid. Now, the solid is cut by a sectional plane. It is perpendicular to VP. So, it is perpendicular to VP and 35 degree inclined to HP. Therefore, our cutting plane is 35 degree inclined to HP like this. This is 35 degree inclined to HP and 25 mm above the HP, where 25 mm above the HP means on axis. Therefore, here first your line joining the diagonals. This is the diagonals. So, this is the center. Therefore, here to center also you draw the projection line, clear? So now this is the center here, center line method, this one, clear? In this case it's cut by a sectional plane 35 degree inclined to HP and perpendicular to VP and 25 mm above HP. Therefore, the total height is 30, clear, cube height. So 25 means it comes here approximately, okay, in this diagram I drawn in approximate dimension. So here the 35 degree line you mark it, understand, 35 degree HP. So like this, clear, this one. So that this is the cutting plane. So cutting plane method also it is like center line one method only, but the ends are thick, and from top to here the arrow mark it indicates from here to here you cut and remove this component, okay? So the observer here, the observer, so the portion nearer to the observer element will be cut and removed, then only we get that hatching surface, clear? So now if we cut and remove this part means the balance element is only this much, okay? Here therefore you made it, this is thin, so only this part only thick. So I'll draw this diagram on your drawing sheet. You made it this part only by H pencil dark, like this, okay? So this part is thin, I understand, because it's cut and removed, right? So now we see that after cut and remove the cutting points, you mention it is A1 edge. Let us consider this is P dash, and here next B2 edge. So this point is Q dash, and this one where the cutting plane is cut, that horizontal surface, definitely we get the two cutting points, two intersection points we get. In only in vertical line it cuts only one cutting points, but where that surface is flat, that is horizontal, definitely we cut two points. Therefore here P, A1 edge P dash, B2 edge Q dash, and the horizontal surface B2C, clear, B2C, so it is R dash. Similarly from C to D, so two surface, no, two edges, so here S dash. Therefore P dash, here Q dash, here R S dashes, clear? And then 4D in this case T dash. So now P Q R S T dashes, any letters, alphabets or numbers we follow, clear, right? So now we see that you draw the projection line from P dash is perfectly coincided with A1. Next Q, that point also is where it comes, the Q is lies between 2 B2. Therefore here this is Q point, this one is P point, clear? And next thing, where is R and S lies? R lies B to C, so B to C R point, and C to D S point. Therefore we draw the projection lines from R and S, but already here P same is coincide, Q that also is coincide, here the R and S, you draw the projection line, that projection line where it is intersecting on the B to C, that point is R, that projection line where it is intersecting on that CD, clear, this point is S, and the T point is lies D4 means, therefore it's also coincide, so this point is T. So P Q R S T. So while cut and remove means this R to S edge is dark, clear, this one is dark. okay, so remaining everything. Now while the plane is cut, definitely we mentioned that hatching surface, clear? The hatching surface is 45 degree inclined to principal plane, and also either 2 mm or 3 mm gap between the each and every lines, and we never cross over the boundary, clear? Therefore take 45 degree lines, 45 degree line by 2 H pencil, thin continuous. The angle is 45 degree, the gap is either 2 mm or 3 mm, all are equi. Then the hatching lines is never cross over the boundary and also never short. Like this, clear? Like. So here the dark, the portion is there, this one also is there, here also is there, but in this area there is no hatching because we are not disturbed that R to C, C to S, this portion is, we are not disturbed, we are not cut anything. Therefore exactly this is completely purely empty, the hatching surface is comes here only. So now this is, this one is front view, this part, and this one is sectional top view. So in this problem, draw the front view, sectional top view and true shape. So while the cutting plane is parallel to principal plane, both the principal plane, means the true shape is equal to top view, hatching surface, that is called frustum. When it is inclined, definitely the true shape, it not same, it comes some other shape, some other cross sectional area, clear? So now we go for how to draw the true shape. Now if you want to draw a true shape, means very simple, this is the cutting plane is there, no? So in that cutting plane you draw the perpendicular line from the cutting points P, Q, R, S and T. You draw perpendicular line here, here and here. So all lines are perpendicular, clear? And also while seeing that, so here the cutting plane is there, no? So same one more line parallel and it's away from component for to avoiding the overlapping of that object. So let us consider now the XY reference line here. Now we go for example X1 Y1 reference line. For our convenient, we assign that letters X1 Y1, clear? So this is the actual cutting plane. So now one more line parallel it, and away from that object. Then from PQRS you draw the perpendicular line from each and every points, clear? So we know that in projection of line topic, the trapezoidal method. So in that case, if you want to draw the actual dimensions here, means we take the top view dimension, you may measure the dimension from XY to P, how much distance is there from XY line to P, same distance, okay, we take from X1 Y1, but instead of XY we take X1 Y1. So XY to P equal to X1 Y1 to from here to here distance is equal to here distance. Then similarly from XY to B point, sorry, Q point, because P, Q, R, S, T, that one only we need. Similarly, from XY to Q point here, that is actually maximum distance. So you mention on that Q line from XY, X1, Y1 here, for example, clear? Like this. So this one is P, it is true shape, therefore true, capital letter P, this is Q, understand? And next, XY to R distance and XY to S distance, both are lies in same projection line, okay, but the distance is different. So from XY to R and XY to S is like market on that RS dash lines from X1, Y1. So we get, for example, so here this is R because this distance here to here. Similar case, XY to S distance here to here. So this is S. Clear. R and S both are lies in same projection. And then XY to T. This is the shortest distance when compared to all other points. So XY to T. Where is the T lies? D4 line. Therefore, XY to T distance is marked from DT line X1 and Y1 to here. This is point T. Clear. Now you join PQRST. This is actual true. So PQRS like this. Clear. Like this. Understand? So this one. So this is the true shape of the component. Clear? Right. So now finally we made it. So here the etching surface is 45 degree to XY. Similarly, here also we must be mentioned that axis etching lines. That line is 45 degree with X1, Y1. Therefore, take protractor. Okay. So 45 degree mark it. So here, 45 degree. Clear? So this is nothing but true shape. This is true shape. This one is sectional top view, and this one is, we know that this is front view. Clear. So this is the solution for the given problem, a cube of side 30 mm. So we mentioned the dimensions as per that standard procedure. We must be follow the rules of dimensioning. Thank you.